to watch Trevin's ball out, get first shot of the game, boost. It's a plus 100 money line for his first shot, so I would boost that. Right now, I'm ready for Travis to nail a three to start the game off.
All right, let's go. Let's see some fire during warm-ups. Thanks for talking, Gibby. Good to see you. Shout out overtime.
Yeah.
I'm here with Foster.
I just want to shout out Jeffrey Ike and the lovely Flock student section. Hell yeah. I got to go warm up.
Okay, let's go, Foster. See you later. That was Foster Kesslering, team manager, one of the seniors on this team. I'm here with Josh Lush. Say hi, Josh.
What's up?
Josh is a CNS volleyball guy. Big JD supporter, though. Yeah, we're going to go back upstairs for now, but I'll be back with more interviews in just a few.
You guys excited for this senior night?
Who do you think is going to score out of the seniors on this team?
I think AJ Semita is going to give him buckets today.
Do you think Trey Evans will make his game, like, at the start of the game, I'm hearing Trey Evans is going to take the first shot. Do you think he'll make it?
I do indeed. Trey is a bucket as well.
Yeah, Luca, what do you think?
I agree. He's a lethal shooter. It's no doubter.
You think Foster will be seeing the court today, or you think he's going to be staying in those khakis?
What'd you say?
You think Foster will see any action, or you think he'll be in those khakis all game?
He will be in the khakis all game.
All right. Any predictions for how this matchup, this rivalry matchup, will shape out today?
I think we're going to come out with a dub, but I'm not going to speak too soon.
Yeah, what do you think about the way ESM reacted to that buzzer beater? Do you think that's class, or do you think that's a little bit unnecessary?
They got lucky, and they're going to have it for them today.
All right, thank you for your time, Tyler. Great to hear from you. Mikey, we'll send it back up to you. All right, Emeka, how's it going today? How'd you sleep last night?
I slept great. I went to bed on time. I'm ready to go.
How was your snow day?
It's great.
Yeah?
Hype.
Are you pumped for this game?
Yeah.
What do you think about the outcome of that last game?
It was heartbreaking, you know. Losing on a buzzer beater, especially in an away game, you never want to see that happen. But, you know, we're hyped. We're ready to go. We're going to win on senior night.
Yeah.
Boys.
Okay. Yeah.
How'd you guys prepare for this matchup?
We practiced hard. We ran a lot, so we're conditioned, you know, and we understand their defense. So we're ready to attack it in any direction, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've been hearing some rumors that Trey Evans will be getting the first shot of the game. Is that true?
Very true. Very true. He will be shooting first.
Do you think he'll be making it or missing it? What's the over-under on that?
There is an 100% chance he's making that.
All right, let's go, Emeka. I love what I'm hearing from you. Good luck today. Go get him during warm-ups. Let's go, buddy. Go get him. That was Emeka. Back up to you guys. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are bringing in a very special guest. I have Mr. Goodson right here. He is bringing over Dr. Peter Smith, the superintendent of Jamesville-DeWitt. Dr. Smith, how's it going today? I'm good. Are you excited for this matchup?
I am very excited for this matchup. Very excited for today.
How was your snow day yesterday?
You know what? I use snow days to get caught up on work, so it was a good day, actually.
Yeah, it was great. It was awesome. Some of my friends and I, we went out and played some hockey. It was a really great day. Yeah, it was really fun. How do you think the buzzer beater last time by ESM beating JD on the last second shot, how do you think that's going to affect this game today?
Oh, I think our guys are going to come out super motivated. I think they're not going to let that happen again. I'm predicting like a 10 to 12 point win. You?
Awesome. Yeah, I think JD, they really took that loss to heart. I think they got that dog in them. I think they're going to come out strong and hopefully get a 10 point victory today.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that too. Who do you think is going to be the leading scorer?
I predict some action from Trent Hughes today, the big man. I could see Ian Delfa making some threes. I think we got some senior leadership. I think it's going to be a great game.
Yeah, great day for senior leaders. Great day to honor our seniors. It's going to be a great day.
Yeah, all right. Thank you, Dr. Smith. I hope you enjoyed the game. Yes, thank you. That was Dr. Peter Smith. And we're going to try to get an interview with Trey Evans. I don't know if this is going to happen. He's a bit distracted. If you want. I don't All right, I'm here with two seniors from the girls' basketball team. I'm here with Paige and Gracie. How are you guys doing today?
Good, how are you?
I'm amazing.
How are you guys feeling? I know your guys' senior night got postponed, but how are you guys feeling about this game today?
We're feeling good. We hope the boys can pull out a win, and we're supporting them, yeah. I agree. Hope they win. It's a big evening game for them.
How do you think this JD team will bounce back after that Cole Thomas buzzer beater at ESM? Do you think they're going to play hard, or do you think they're going to come out with a win today?
I think they'll definitely play hard, come out strong, and keep the intensity throughout the game. I feel like their third and fourth quarters aren't their strongest, so I hope that they learn and pass the ball well and get it inside the paint, get that dub.
All right, thank you guys for your time. Enjoy the matchup. Send it back up to you, Mikey. All right. Aaron. I'm here with Mr. Greg Lawson. Mr. Lawson, how's it going today? Good to see you.
How are you?
Yeah, how do you feel? What's the atmosphere in this building? Like, what does this all mean to you?
Well, it's pretty exciting right now, which is great. I think it's going to get a little bit better. The JV game ended pretty fun the last 5 minutes, so we'll see what happens here. Everyone's pretty focused and locked in, though.
Oh, yeah. So the last game between these two teams, we had Cole Thomas nail a buzzer beater. How do you think that sunk in with the Red Rams? How do you think they're going to come out today and just win as a team?
Well, I think the last few days here, people have been set on this, so I think they're ready to go. Even during the JV game, they were focused, so we'll see.
Yeah, and can you talk to the people at home about the flock, these T-shirts I see them wearing? What's going on with that?
Well, we just have a pretty engaged student section, so we want to keep that going. We're trying to get everyone in red today and let them be loud.
Yeah, I hope it's going to be an awesome game. I want to thank you for your time. I hope you enjoyed the game. I love your sneakers, by the way. Those are awesome. That was Mr. Greg Lawson, the principal.
administration. My favorite basketball memory with the team has been on the bus rides home after away games and just chilling with the boys. We would also like to recognize our senior student manager, Foster.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time has finally come. Welcome to JDTV and welcome to Jamesville-DeWitt High School for this matchup between the Jamesville-DeWitt Red Rams and the ESM Spartans. My name is Michael Meskos, one of the many voices of the Red Rams. Today I'm joined by Will Cooper, my broadcast partner, for the broadcast of this game. Will, this is probably the biggest game of the Red Rams season. How are you feeling today?
You know, I think this is a huge game for the Red Rams, coming off that buzzer beat loss. Cole Thomas with the basket at the end of regulation there. The Red Rams on senior night looking to get a huge league win in a rivalry game at home in front of a huge crowd. I know these boys want this one badly, so I hope they can pull it out.
Like you said, it is senior night. The JD Red Rams are rocking with a little bit different starting lineup with Samita, Ogata, Stickle, Delpha, and Trey Evans in the starting lineup as ESM wins a tip. I'm going to make a bold prediction and say that Trey Evans, the second he touches the ball, that shot is going up. He has the green light going into this game. Here's Tristan Henderson trying to back down Samita, and he gets his first bucket of the afternoon.
Yeah, Henderson, a big guy in the lane, looking to make a presence with that tall build. Let's see how Hughes, once he checks in the game, can match up against Henderson.
Here's Stickle. Here's Trey Evans looking open. Oh, he decides against the shot for the first time. Likely will not be the last time he touches the ball. Here's Stickle sizing up, tries to drive, but kicks out to Ogata in the corner. Here's Ogata. Cannot get the three. The ball is tipped. Will go off the hands of Tyler Corey for Red Rams basketball.
Yeah, it looked like A.J. Samita went over the back of number 21. That's Tyler Corey for ESM. A.J. Samita looking to make his presence known on the boards.
Here's Ogata to inbound, back to Stickle, and the Red Rams have a fresh 35-second shot clock to work with. Here's Samita, catches it at the foul line. Delpha steps out to the wing. Tries to shake off Andrew Graham. Here's Stickle for three from the wing. In and out. Samita tries to track it down, but it ends up getting picked up by Tyler Corey.
Yeah, the Red Rams with a lot of ball movement there on offense. Hopefully they can get something going a little more cohesive. And A.J. Samita pokes that away. It's going to stay with the Spartans.
Samita sizing up against the much bigger Tristan Henderson already, and we are getting our first substitutions of the game already. Ogata, Samita, and most sadly, Trey Evans are checking out. And the normal Red Rams starting lineup is back in. Here's Corey trying to size up Zanders, who just checked in. Back out to his point guard, Anthony Bryant.
Yeah, Bryant on Delpha, number three on number three. 2 point guards looking to make an impact in this game early.
Yeah, Delpha with the size disadvantage, but that just means he will have to make up for it with his quickness and speed just a little bit more. But Bryant gets the better of him already and gets the better of Trent Hughes. Hughes picks up the foul. Bryant gets the and one. Looks to go to the free throw line to complete the three-point play.
Yeah, nice move there from Bryant. You know, a thing to watch for the Red Rams is Trent Hughes. He tends to get into foul trouble. They don't want him to get into trouble early, so hopefully they can limit those little gimmick fouls.
Bryant misses, and as you can hear, the flock is in full force today. The snow day did not hinder us at all. This is probably our best student section of the year, and we need it for the biggest game of the year.
Yeah, we do need this student section here. Some of the basketball games have had some rather lackluster crowds, but hopefully they can get into this one.
Here's Hughes down below off the feed from Zanders, but just gets caught under the rim. And Andrew Graham looks to push the pace. Here's Graham goes up. Stickle defends nicely. It gets batted around, but here's Hughes, and here come JD on the break. Here's Zanders pushing the pace. Had Giblin under the basket, but couldn't quite get to him in time. And back out to Stickle. Here's Giblin out to Hughes, top of the key. Oh, tries to find Stickle underneath, but it's picked up by Corey.
Yeah, good ball movement there from the Red Rams, but a lazy pass, and that ends up in a turnover. They got to really be conscious with their passes, making sure they're making smart moves. Can't have too many takeaways and end up with a win.
And there goes Austin Betts off the feed from Corey. That's a great move. Great job getting open. He just gets his first bucket. And the Red Rams are scoreless in the first 3 minutes.
Yeah, it looks like Jake Ogata is going to check back in for the Red Rams. Hopefully he's going to provide a little bit of a spark here as the Red Rams on offense have looked rather quiet, some turnovers.
Yeah, Ogata's getting a lot of minutes in recent games. Started the season not playing a whole lot, but he's kind of resurrected his playing time. And I know Coach Ike trusts him a lot. He's a senior leader, as we saw him getting recognized on senior night. Here comes the sophomore, Alan Zanders, will get fouled in the lane. Go to the free throw line for his first two, a place where he struggled a little bit so far this season. Missed a couple of key free throws in games like Fowler and Central Square. Looking to get off on the right foot and get the Red Rams on the board for the first time.
Yeah, Xander's a guy that likes to get in, make ball movement, and just go off the drive. And as he makes that free throw, Xander's the kind of guy that gets into the lane, gets fouled, puts up tough shots. So a guy that can provide a real spark for this offense.
As we saw, Jake Ogata now checking in for Eamon Giblin. Xander misses a second, but the offensive rebound's tracked down for Hughes. Here's Stickle on the wing. Stickle Euro steps, tries to get around Henderson, and he gets it down.
Wow. What a move there from Stickle, you know, a senior on this team looking to provide much-needed leadership.
Stickle doing what he does best, providing a spark. He's had a couple of lackluster performances recently, taking a lot of shots, not necessarily hitting as many. Trying to get a spark, but Anthony Bryant sizes up the much smaller Ian Delphi. He gets his second basket of the day. And here comes Anders.
Yeah, nice move from Bryant. They need to really stop that underneath look. That's two easy layups for him, so hopefully they can figure out a way to stop him on the drive and the layups.
Here's Delphi with a drive of his own, but it's batted from behind by Tyler Quarry. Tyler Quarry with the size advantage, as most of his team has over the JD Red Rams.
Yeah, the only person on the Red Rams team that really can size up to these bigs on ESM is Trent Hughes, who now has the ball, and he drives on Henderson. Nice move there from Hughes.
Yeah,
what a move from Trent. Trying to attack Mr. Tristan Henderson, a volleyball player himself, but hopefully the Red Rams can figure an answer, stop Henderson down low.
Here's Corey once again. Out to Austin Betts. Austin Betts with a mid-range. Nice little J from about 13 feet, and he gets it down.
Yeah, Betts with that length. He just rose up above the defenders, put it up where they couldn't block it, and just sunk the jump shot. A nice look there for Austin Betts. But hopefully the Red Rams can answer. Again, here comes
Sanders, a little jumper of his own, and gets absolutely nothing. It's saved by Hughes, but into the hands of Andrew Graham. Here's ESM pushing the pace. Here's Anthony Bryant, and he will be fouled by Alan Sanders. A little bit of a wild take up to the basket, but it will result in two free throws for Bryant.
Yeah, tough play there. A nice steal there by Trent Hughes to keep the ball in bounds. However, it didn't really end up with much of anything. Instead, a fast break for the Spartans. So Red Rams kind of got a break there, but ends up with free throws on the foul.
And as Bryant misses his first, Will, what do you think the Red Rams need to focus on right now with 3 minutes left in this first quarter?
I think the Red Rams need to focus on really just attacking on offense and also being well thought out on defense, really not letting anybody get easy baskets, not letting anybody get into the paint for an easy look on the layups. It looks like so far the Red Rams have allowed a couple easy layups. Hopefully they can limit that, force the Spartans into shooting some tough shots, but that won't help as they turn it over. Turnovers will never help you on offense.
The Red Rams just don't look like they're on the same page right now. Between Xanders and Stickle getting goofed up in the backcourt a little bit, Xanders throwing a pass just where no one is to be found. Got to get this situated before it gets out of hand quickly. Ball will go off Trent Hughes, it looks like, as Tristan Henderson tried to back him down in the post. Ball will stay with ESM, where they have a six-point lead with 3 minutes left in the first quarter.
Yeah, the Spartans have yet to make a substitution. Who knows how that'll play into this game. Looks like Cole Thomas is still on the bench. Maybe he'll check in, but hopefully the Red Rams can keep putting in some fresh legs. But a travel is called. Another turnover. You know, I think turnovers will play a huge part in this game. Hopefully the team that can limit the turnovers will turn out with the win. But speaking of which, number five for the Spartans checks in. That's Micah Combs, the first substitution.
Yeah, and like you said, Cole Thomas yet to check in. He's actually the leading scorer of this ESM team. He averages about 12.5 points per game, but he is perhaps most well known in the JD community for his buzzer beater, his heroics against JD last game. Here's Ogata, gets a little floater, cannot corral it.
A nice strong rebound from Betts. Betts really climbed the ladder for that one, so hopefully the Red Rams can figure out an answer.
Here's Graham in the corner, gets a three up, cannot get it down. Ogata corrals it. And like I was saying with Cole Thomas, there's a lot of bad blood between him and the Red Rams fans. I expect some chirps, maybe some chants against him, anything to shake him off his game.
Yeah, the Red Rams got to watch out for Andrew Graham there. Fortunately, he didn't make that three, but I remember from watching the last ESM game, he couldn't miss that three ball, but Ian misses that one, unfortunately.
Red Rams have struck it cold so far. Only a couple of baskets and a free throw made so far. Here's Henderson. TH against TH down there in the post. Oh, it's almost batted away against by Ian Delpha. Spartans will retain possession, however.
Yeah, Combs has a notable size advantage on Delpha. Hopefully Delpha won't let that get the better of him. But now Bryant in the paint.
Bryant with a head of steam, but it's batted away by Trent Hughes. But in the tie-up between Bryant and Hughes, the ball will stay with Anthony Bryant and the ESM Spartans, as it looks like Bryant may have gotten poked in the eye.
Yeah, Coach Ike looking for a foul there. He's talking to one of the officials. You know, from my angle, it did look like Trent Hughes was pushed in the back. However, the foul was not called. The ball will stay with the Spartans. Hopefully the Red Rams don't let this get the better of them.
And with that, looks to be eye injury from Anthony Bryant. Trey Bova will check in for his first minutes of the game. Still no sight of Cole Thomas. Possibly trying to maybe throw Coach Ike and the rest of the Red Rams coaching staff off a little bit. Never know when he's going to come in. And the Red Rams, the flock, are feeling it right now. Trying to get ESM rattled with 2 minutes left in this quarter. Ball is batted away, but Delphi wasn't looking. It was right in his hands. All he had to do was turn around, but the ESM Spartans keep the ball.
Yeah, it appeared the flock was getting into it because Coach Jim Patrick of the Spartans was quite vocal. Wanted the officials to start the basketball game, but the flock letting into him there. And now Tristan gets into trouble. Oh, God ends up with it on the floor. And he throws it off of Henderson's foot. A very smart move there from Jake Ogata. You know, that'll come with just playing a lot of basketball.
Yeah, Tristan Henderson was dribbling with his head completely down. That's something I tell my third and fourth grade basketball players at JDYA to not do. And when you're a senior on this team, that is absolutely not what you want to do, because a player like Jake Ogata will swoop it up at a moment's notice. Here's Hughes underneath. Jackson Cerrone with his first minutes of the game. Fires the three and puts it down.
Yeah, great look there from Cerrone. Absolutely no defenders in the area to speak of. What a look. What a find there from Trent Hughes. A beautiful assist. Hopefully the Red Rams can keep getting that dish and drive action to create open looks.
Cerrone, the sophomore, has struggled a little bit, as here is a missed shot by Andrew Graham. Trent Hughes corrals.
Yeah,
despite Cerrone's struggles, he gets off with his first 3 points on the board at a very opportune time. Here's Delphi.
The crowd getting into it. Hopefully the Red Rams can even this one up or make it a close one-point game. They really need to swing the possession here.
Stickle thought about it. Instead takes a highly contested mid-range jumper. A very ill-advised shot for Stickle as he completely airballs it over two defenders. Probably should have taken the three instead. But hindsight is 20-20, as we know.
Yeah. Now Henderson, the big man up top. Poked away. Oh, what a move by Ogata. Oh, but he traveled as he fell to the ground.
Ogata so active already on the defensive end. He is not giving Henderson, Corey, any of those guys, Trey Bova, any of them, any breathing room right now. And that's possibly why his minutes have seen a large increase since the start of this season.
Yeah, you know, I'm noticing Graham has been really silent shooting the ball. The Spartans have not looked to get him involved, but now here he has the ball. So hopefully the Red Rams can lock him down. Oh, he puts
Graham
it off the backboard.
The other side of the backboard, but is then fouled by, I believe, Trent Hughes. That was a pretty soft foul call. It looked like Trent Hughes got away with a clean block, but looks like Graham's wrist was just slapped a little bit there by Hughes as he will go to the line shooting two.
Yeah, that was a tough foul there. The Red Rams looking to just stop the Spartans' offensive momentum. Here's a big free throw for Graham. And it's off the front iron.
And the flock doing a great job. That student section has filled out quite nicely so far. Possibly our biggest student section of the game, and we need it the most right now as Andrew Graham takes his second. He misses his second, but it was a lane violation.
A lane violation,
ESM,
yes. Quite a very influential turn of events there for the Red Rams as they will now get the ball free possession. Didn't even have to wait for the missed shot.
And that turnover is all because of the flock and their antics. Here's Hughes at the free throw line trying to get a floater. Gets his own rebound with 1 second left, and the Red Rams cannot get a shot up. The ball is batted around quite a bit. But we will go out of the first quarter with an 11-8 lead for the ESM Spartans. A couple of buckets by Jackson Cerrone down the stretch. But ESM still have a lead, not a comfortable one, but any lead is a good lead so far. Will, what do you like out of ESM right now?
Out of ESM, I'm seeing them getting some good action in the paint. They're putting up good layups, getting good looks down low. They are very quiet. I believe they've missed the only three they've attempted, and they've missed a couple jump shots. Aiden Betts had that nice floater in the lane that went up and in, but I think the Spartans, for their offense, they got to get some good looks out on the three with Graham. Red Rams got to figure out a way to stop the Spartans' attack underneath the hoop. Hopefully Trent Hughes can help them on that. Trent Hughes, I noticed that was a beautiful move in the paint at the end of the first quarter. However, he coughed it up, kind of lost his handle, ended up losing the possession there. But if Trent Hughes had held onto it, I would have seen a nice, emphatic, possibly a dunk But he looked to finish there, couldn't quite finish. So hopefully Trent Hughes can figure that out.
Yeah, speaking of the dunk, I told Eamon Giblin, I told him, hey, today's the day, let it fly. We've only got a couple of home games left, only a couple broadcasts left on JDTV, but aside from that Spencer Wellington dunk from Fowler, we have not seen any dunks for the Red Rams. The time is ticking, but hey, with the flock in full force like they are today, today would be the absolute perfect day. Everyone in this gym wearing a red or white shirt would absolutely love it. As here we go into the second quarter of action, Cole Thomas has checked into the game for the first time. Possibly will stay in for this entire second quarter.
Yeah, hopefully Cole Thomas, if you're a Spartans fan, you're looking for him to make an instant impact. But here's Delph in the lane. Oh, a wonderful move by Delph to keep that alive.
Falls, but gets it, recovers to Jake Ogata. Here's Cerrone working. Back to Ogata. Here's Hughes around the foul line area. Delph on the wing. Delph getting double teamed, but is now brought up by Micah Combs. Here's another three from Jackson Cerrone. He's heating up. The sophomore is backpacking the Red Rams so far.
Yeah, Cerrone has the hot hand. I say, while he's hot, let him cook. You know, we're going to throw some polls up in the chat. Feel free to leave a chat in the comments if you have something you want us to say. And here it's stripped away by Delpha. Some smart defense from Delpha to take it away from Cole Thomas. Cole looks quite frustrated after that one.
And perhaps the Red Rams will look for Cerrone as he has the hot hand, but another errant pass. Ian Delpha just passes it over the head of Jake Ogata.
Yeah, another turnover.
A real
there.
Vibe kill. Once again, we'd like to remind you, as Will was saying, we do have a comment section here on JDTV for all of our viewers. Let us know something you like about this game. Maybe cheer for a certain player or team. Any comment is appreciated.
Yeah.
Here's Combs sizing up. Oof. Oh, scoops it underneath. Almost gets the foul. Or excuse me, almost gets the and one, but the foul will be called once again on Trent Hughes. Believe that is his second or third. His third of the game. Possibly Coach Ike will take him out in just a sec, but not what you want to see from Trent Hughes. As obviously, as we know, availability is the best ability. As Micah Combs takes his first, misses his first off the back iron. The Flock's antics are continuing to make the ESM Spartans miss every free throw they've taken almost.
Yeah, not to say I called it, but I did say earlier that Trent Hughes' foul trouble would be something to watch. Also, I'd like to mention Coach Ike calling out for his team to run four low. Coach Ike wanting his seniors to set up an offense. Ike appeared to be very frustrated when Delpha threw that ball away. He's looking for a specific offense to be set up. Hopefully they can figure that out.
Here's Delpha out to Cerrone again with a hot hand. He takes it again. What can he do? Oh, hits it back iron. And the ball will stay with JD as Stickle and Graham tracked it down, but Graham got the last hand on it.
Graham looking to make a play there to maybe throw it off a Stickle, but he couldn't quite get what he wanted. Looks
and
like
Cerrone so far is feeling it from long range.
Yeah, that was his first miss, but
yeah,
he's 2 for 3.
Check.
Yeah.
Here's Stickle sizing up Combs. Stickle drives over the much taller Henderson. Throws it up, but just nothing going on for Stickle as Cole Thomas with his first touch. And the Red Rams are booing every time he touches the ball. They hate this guy. These two schools, these two teams absolutely hate each other. A long history of bad blood.
Yeah, the Spartans setting up this offense with Tristan Henderson at the top of the key. But again, like I said, the Spartans looking to create off the blocks, down low in the paint. Cole Thomas with a nice layup there. The Red Rams really got to figure out an answer, stop the Spartans from getting down low. And here's Cerrone with another three, and he cashes in! Another three from Jackson Cerrone. That's 9 points for the young man. 3 for 4 from beyond the arc, and the Red Rams have a 1-point lead. It's 14-13 with about 6 minutes to go. Hopefully we'll get these video problems figured out. Henderson can't get it to go. Ooh, a strong rebound from Cole, but Mr. Cole Thomas was fouled very hard there. Ian Delpha called with the hit. Now the Spartans will inbound. I'm very sorry for these technical difficulties with the camera. We're getting it squared away really quickly. Looks like we're back here with the camera. Very sorry about that, folks.
Once again, we are back. Technical difficulties cannot stop us. And they cannot stop Jackson Cerrone either, as in the break, he canned his third three of the afternoon. We're good. And yeah, the Red Rams get their first lead of the game, 14-13. Here's Colt Thomas going to inbound. Likely to receive a lot of boos here from the JD student section. Here's Thomas backing up Stickle. Goes for the post hook, misses at front rim.
Oh.
And Hughes picks it up. JD hopefully trying to get out to a little bit more than a 1-point lead.
Yeah, bad miss there from Cole Thomas. That appeared to be a little bit of a selfish play. But hopefully the Red Rams can be a little less selfish and facilitate some action, but a foul is called.
And Cerrone's fouled. He's staying in for a really long time, and why not? He's got the most points on this team with 9. Coach Ike is trusting him, and as I say that, he's bringing in the other sophomore on this team, Alan Zanders. Trusting the young guys to get it done, obviously with a couple of senior leaders like Stickle and Ogata on the floor, but Coach Ike is running with the young guys.
Yeah, quite interesting here. AJ Samita has not really seen much action in this game other than at the start of the game. And now Stickle cashes in from 3. The Red Rams are very hot from behind the arc. They open up a 4-point lead here over the Spartans with 5 minutes to go. And that was Corey.
Momentum is shifting in the Red Rams' favor. Now have hit 4 threes, and here we go again. Tristan Henderson, absolutely no skill in the post. Travels. Anthony Stickle is loving it. The flock is loving it, telling him you can't do that.
Yeah, man, I hope Tristan Henderson enjoyed that trip. Hopefully enjoyed his travels, but the Red Rams are going to take that one away from him and looking to make this lead even bigger as they are up by 4 points.
Here's Sanders sizing up. Tries to find Ogata down below again, but for the third time, a pass that goes to Jake Ogata is batted away. The ball will stay with the Red Rams as ESM call the first time out. Coach Jim Kilpatrick wanted to talk some stuff over.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of different looks for both these teams so far. The Spartans have been a team, they're feeding it down low. They're looking to get guys involved in the paint. We've seen Cole Thomas and Anthony Bryant making some tough layups down low. The Red Rams so far, they've been a dish and drive kind of team. I've seen Jackson Cerrone, Anthony Stickle now getting hot from behind the arc. The Red Rams holding on to a 4-point lead with 4:41 here to go in the second quarter. So we'll see how this plays out. It looks like, I'm being told here that Coach Jake Klein is in the building. We see him over there in the corner. He's waving this way. That's a state champion coach right there. We had the boys volleyball state championship ceremony coming up at halftime. Hopefully you guys will stay tuned and see that.
Yep, just about 5 minutes left in this second quarter before that ceremony. Here's Cerrone still staying in. Dishes out to Hughes as here is Stickle. Here's Cerrone in the corner again. Finds Hughes on the roll. Hughes gets the matchup against Andrew Graham, but will go to the line. A great free throw shooter, Trent Hughes is.
Yeah, Coach Ike is very emphatic telling Cerrone that was a great play, and indeed it was, as Hughes had an awesome look inside there. You know, Coach Ike liking what he's seeing from the sophomore, Mr. Jackson Cerrone, and Trent Hughes unfortunately couldn't get that to fall, but he did these free throws. Can't make the first one, though.
And Hughes looking for a 5-point lead for his team with 4:35 left. Up it goes, and he misses both, and the rebound is tracked down by Graham. Here comes ESM, trying to push the pace, need a little bit of urgency here, obviously halftime, but do not want to have this shooting slump continue as long as it did. Here's Graham getting fouled by Jake Ogata on the drive, will go to the line for 2.
Yeah, ESM looking to climb their way back into this one, finding themselves down by 4 points. You know, they're going to need to get some offense going here. They don't want to be taking a deficit into halftime. It looks like Amir Zahirovich will be heading to the bench. Or heading to the scorers table, excuse me. Hopefully he'll get some nice action here. Let's go, Amir. Graham can't make his first free throw.
Amir Zahirovic, one of the only guys on this team that can dunk. And the ESM. Red Rams are loving it.
Yeah. Let's go, Amir. The Spartans are 0-6, I'm hearing. 0-6 from the line. Oh.
Make it 1-7.
Make it 1-7, but still, that's quite abysmal.
As here comes Zahirovic for his first minutes of the afternoon. Here's Sanders.
He's the tallest on the court currently. Maybe we'll see him throw one down. Oh, here he is, Amir, with the ball. He coughs it up a little bit, but he passes it out to Stickle. Fakes the 3, drives. Foul.
Stickle's fouled, and he gets it down.
Oh, on the floor, on the floor. The official's waving it off, saying it was on the floor.
Oh, Anthony Stickle.
One official saying on the floor, one official saying on the shot. What will it be?
Let's see. The scoreboard already said it was 19-14. They're counting it as 2. Based on Stickle's body language, it looks like, I am so confused right now. It looks like Coach Jim Kilpatrick for the Spartans is arguing with the referees. It looks like that basket's going to count. Anthony Stickle with the off balance, getting fouled, throws a prayer up at the rim and gets the shooter's roll, and he will take 1 free throw.
It looks like they're going to give Stickle the shot. Foul on the shot, not on the floor. A wonderful turn of events here for the Red Rams. Not quite for the Spartans. Let's see what Stickle can do.
Gets it up and
Yeah, Coach Jim Kilpatrick quite frustrated with that, but now the Red Rams open up a 6-point lead. Largest lead of the game either way. It's 20-14 here. Spartans looking to answer quickly as they hope this deficit doesn't get too out of hand. Cole Thomas looking to create on the dribble. He gets in the lane. I don't know. That might have been a travel.
Oh, wow. I don't know about that.
That
Cole
looked like
Thomas
a travel
with a little
up here,
jump
but,
stop.
You know.
Maybe a gather step, but it looks like he took a couple. But not to worry for ESM as he gets his first basket at a much, much needed time.
Yeah, just like we were calling for a foul up here on Cole Thomas, some of the ESM fans in the building calling for a travel on Anthony Stickle as Anthony Stickle looked to gather and make some fancy moves there as he looked to drive the paint. And now the Red Rams are inbounding the ball here. Oh, it's stolen. Bryant pokes it away, but nothing will come out of that.
And the body language from Bryant, he really wanted that one back. And it kind of reflects all of ESM's struggles right now. They just cannot get the pieces all put together. They've got a couple nice drives, a couple good sequences on offense and defense. Here's Zanders on the trail.
Stickle with a nice assist. Stickle finds the cutting Allen Zanders. Great ball movement. Way to be not selfish, Mr. Anthony Stickle. The Red Rams now up by, I believe,
six.
That is six. Yes.
Stickle was getting
again.
Triple teamed, but he found the cutter, Allen Zanders. Such a nice off-ball movement there as ESM are in their largest deficit of the day. Here is Bryant trying to get something working, but he can hardly hear his teammates over the shouts of the flock. Here's Cole Thomas sizing up. Here's Quarry on the wing. Here's Quarry, but it's batted away by Hughes. But Cole Thomas picks it up, takes an off-balance shot. Looks like he kind of ran into...
Yeah, I was going to say that was more of Cole Thomas falling into the Red Rams there than it was the Red Rams committing a foul. I don't understand that.
And
that
will go on Jake Ogata.
Yeah.
Cole Thomas will head to the line. I think we will be hearing some... pretty strange noises from the flock, maybe some chirps, some animal noises. You never know with these guys. Cole Thomas gets his first one up. Cannot get it. The ESM Spartans are now 1-for-8 from the free throw line, sitting at 12.5%.
Yeah,
that is absolutely awful.
We have a very important free throw coming up. This one could decide the fate of the game. And he cashes it in.
Gets the second one. Two falls, excuse me.
I was looking to psych out Cole Thomas there. Didn't quite work. Maybe we can try that again later. Red Rams still up by 5. 2 minutes and 30 seconds to go here. It is now Ogata's inside.
Ogata nice. On the block.
Finds the driving Cerrone and it rattles in.
Jackson Cerrone up to 11 points on the day. A similar play to what we just saw with Stickle and Zanders. Jake Ogata with some hold up, finding the cutter. A nice friendly roll there from Cerrone.
Here's
Cole Thomas with some booze coming his way.
The Red Rams, these last two possessions, have found that cutting player. Now looking to find Graham on the outside, but Ogata sadly kicks it away. Ogata pretty frustrated with that, but no worries. Still a 7-point lead.
The second Cole Thomas picked up his dribble, he was met with a 5-on-1. Jake Ogata tried to bat it away, but the ball will stay with ESM. But ESM are looking sloppy right now. They cannot get any looks inside. Every pass they make looks unsure. Oh, but there we go with Cole Thomas. Kisses it off the glass, gets a nice reverse layup over the outstretched arms of Trent Hughes, and that's another foul on Trent Hughes. Looks to be either his third or fourth, as Samita will likely check in for him right away.
Yeah, you know, the Red Rams got to be cautious here, as just like I said, Trent Hughes will check out due to foul trouble. Here comes AJ Samita, some of his first action in this game. AJ Samita, fan favorite up here in the booth, but the Red Rams really need to limit those fouls on Hughes. Hopefully they can figure that out.
And Cole Thomas completes the old-fashioned three-point play. A 24-20 lead still for JD. With 2 minutes left in the second quarter, it looks like Ian Delfa is about to check in soon. Here's Stickle sizing up Bryant. Jake Ogata trying to facilitate a little bit. Back to Stickle.
A nice
Samita
jab
on
step
the block.
From Ogata.
Stickle with a step back, pump fake, gets the three, and he puts it down. Anthony Stickle is second in the afternoon. At the perfect time, he's feeling it. He's smiling. The flock is loving it.
Yeah, that's Stick's second three of the afternoon. Hopefully he can keep getting hot from behind the arc. They need Stick to come up big in this game on senior night.
Here's Bova out to Quarry, out to Graham. Here's Cole Thomas sizing up Samita.
AJ, come on.
Samita's got to hold his ground. Zanders and Samita tied it up, and it'll be a jump ball between Zanders and Cole Thomas. Not a foul.
Wonderful defense there from my guy, AJ Samita. Great job down low. Matching up on Mr. Cole Thomas there. That's going to be a huge matchup as we look to figure out how we can stop Cole Thomas from getting those drives and baskets off the glass.
And the possession arrow will stay with ESM as a timeout is called from Jeff Ike, looking to talk it over with 1:25 left in the second quarter, first half.
Yeah, let's see what Coach Jeff Ike can figure out here as the Red Rams set up on defense, looking to stop the Spartans from getting any easy baskets. You know, if I was the Red Rams on defense, I was looking. Oh, it looks like Austin Betts is over there working with an athletic trainer. It looks like he's maybe working on that ankle, maybe shaking up. But like I was saying, the Red Rams, if I was looking to set up a good defensive look, I would try to do everything I can to keep the Spartans from getting into the paint and make the Spartans force an outside shot. The Red Rams have really made the Spartans shoot a lot from the inside. The Spartans, they've been quiet from outside the arc, especially outside the paint, so hopefully that'll...
Here is Bryant on the inbound, a 7-point deficit that ESM find themselves in. Kicks it out to Thomas, back to Bryant in the post. Sizing up Stickle, gets a beautiful little spin move around Stickle.
Not to say I called it, but as I was saying, the Red Rams needed to stop the Spartans from getting down low and putting things off the glass, and that's exactly what the Spartans did. You know, the Red Rams really need to crack down on that in the paint, as I keep saying time and time again.
Here's JD with their small ball lineup. Here's Stickle, dishes underneath the basket, AJ Samita.
Yeah, quite a hack there.
He is fouled by Corey and Micah Combs. I think that will go on Tyler Corey, but AJ Samita, one of the best free throw shooters on this team, possibly the best, as I've heard stories of him making up to 60 free throws in a single practice.
Well, unfortunately, you did jinx our guy AJ Samita as he did not make that shot there, but yeah, that foul was quite audible. You could hear that from all corners of this gymnasium. Hopefully Samita can cash in on this second free throw.
Samita gets it up, gets the roll. A 28-22 lead for JD with just under a minute left.
Yeah, the Red Rams looking to hold on to at least a sizable lead at halftime. You know, maybe 5 or 6 points would be nice heading into halftime. But now we get some chance from the flock. The Red Rams setting up on defense.
Corey loses it. Here's Cerrone, picks it up. Cerrone pushes the pace, decides to slow it down. Not going to go for the 2-for-1. We'll hold out for his team's final possession.
Yeah, the Red Rams, there's about a 5 second, or yeah, it looks like a 6 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Stickle can't get the floater to go. Samita almost batted that in.
Stickle recovers, though, underneath the basket, gets it tied up. He's on a 3-on-1, but kicks out to Delpha. And now the shot clock is off. ESM will not get the ball again. The ball is batted away by Tyler Corey, but the ball will stay with JD. Although Stickle missed the floater, that's still a great offensive rebound because it eliminates the shot clock and eliminates the possibility of an ESM possession.
Yeah, Coach Aguilon, one space out, looking to tell his team, direct some offense, telling him what to do here with this possession. As Cerrone inbounds to Samita, there's 11 seconds, make that 10 seconds to go here in the first half.
Here's Zanders, Cerrone, Samita on the roll, finds Stickle trailing, gets the ball up, kisses it off the glass. Here's Bryant trying to get a half-court heave, loses it, will not take a shot. And Anthony Stickle brings JD into halftime with an 8-point lead.
Yeah. I'm going to head out now. We're going to have the banner presentation. I hope you guys tune in. Mikey, it's been a pleasure so far. I'll be back soon.
Do not go anywhere. To all of our viewers, we will see the presentation of the JD Volleyball State Championship banner here at halftime. Our guys, Will Cooper, Tim Cooper, Luke McQuaid, and Aaron Coe, to name a few, will go on down there. But please do not go anywhere. We will be right back in 10 minutes for the start of the second half.
are easily achieved, while others seem nearly impossible. Your team has truly succeeded in meeting many of its goals. Henry Ford once said, coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is success. This quote truly embodies the mission of interscholastic-based athletics and the lessons learned throughout the season. Your team experienced great success, portraying hard work and
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to JDTV. We apologize for any technical difficulties you may have experienced during that halftime break while we recognized the state champion, Jamesville-DeWitt Red Ram volleyball team. A couple of our broadcast members were part of that team, namely Aaron Coe, my broadcast partner who will be returning in just a sec, Will Cooper. But we are very excited to be rid of our technical difficulties and bringing this broadcast back to you right where we left off. With the beginning of the second half of basketball, the JD Red Rams are at an 8-point advantage right now over their fiercest rivals, the ESM Spartans. Jackson Cerrone has been lighting it up so far. Anthony Stickle with a couple of clutch threes. So we're very excited for these remaining 16 minutes of this game. Joining me now is Will Cooper, state champion, volleyball player. Also, Luke McQuaid is back in the booth, but here comes Will Cooper. Will, we're going to take a second to just step away from basketball. How was that presentation?
You know, that was great. We had Mr. Senator John Mannion in the building. You know, great to shake his hand. Great to recognize a team, get the banner up in the rafters with the rest of them. You know, a great day for Jamesville-DeWitt Volleyball, I'd have to say.
Yeah, once again, congratulations. Our first state championship in a couple years. As we are back to action, here is Zanders looking for Giblin in the little
13-footer.
There we go, Gibby.
Yeah, hopefully Eamon Gibble can get hot here in the second half. He's a great defender, great hustle player. Red Rams looking to get a lot out of their sophomore there.
Here's the TH battle once again. Henderson on Hughes. And Henderson gets a little friendly roll. Gets ESM's and his first bucket of the second half. It's now 32-24 with the Red Rams lead. Here's Stickle sizing up.
Yeah, the battle of the TH's.
In the post. Here's Delpha from way downtown. Oh. And he gets the ball stuck, wedges it into the rim. Ian Delpha taking his second consecutive heat check in this second half. Now what you want to be seeing is that ball is completely stuck up there and it will be back in the hands of Anthony Bryant. Here's Bryant. to Betts, out to Thomas. Down low to Henderson. What can he do?
Oh, a turnover!
Tries to cutting Bryant, but here comes Delpha off the picked-up turnover. Decides to slow it down. Tries to make the pass out to Giblin, but it's batted away, and here comes Cole Thomas. Finds Bryant on the break, but Giblin takes it away again, and it will stay with ESM.
Yeah, some reckless passing there by both teams. Thankfully, the Red Rams end up with little damage done.
Here's Thomas to inbound. Thomas tries to post up on the smaller Stickle. Cannot get that post layup like he's tried to get a couple times. It'll be a jump ball, but the ball will stay with JD. Once again, we'd like to remind you, for all of our viewers, that we do have a comment section. Please put any of your comments that you'd like to have a shout out on air, maybe some analysis, maybe some shout outs. Anything you would like to say, feel free. As here is Ian Delpha. Gets a quick first step to get around Graham. Fies Stickle on the wing, but Henderson intercepts it before it can get to Stickle. Here's Thomas with a great feed to Graham.
Wow.
But Graham cannot finish in a man's board.
Graham has been very cold so far this game. I believe Graham has maybe 1 or 2 points. He has been quiet behind the arc, quiet all over the court, but now the Red Rams are going to set up on offense.
Sanders with a tough take, and he gets the bucket. Alan Sanders has been very efficient today, something we may not have seen from him earlier on in the season, so we're seeing real-world development right in front of our eyes.
Yeah, Sanders looking to always make a presence in the lane. He always gets that drive to the basket. Very smart play there from Sanders.
And he gets JD a 10-point lead. Here's Henderson. The pick and roll with Bryant got Hughes off of Henderson. And the bucket by Tristan Henderson cuts the lead to 8. Here's Sanders with the ball again. Here's Stickle on the wing. Ball's batted away by Graham, and it looks, oh yes, Graham will pick it up. Austin Betts gets it, but Giblin is not having any of that, but the ball will stick with Graham as he looks to push the pace. And Graham traveled. A huge vibe kill, killing ESM's momentum. Graham traveled, and it looks like, yep, JD will keep the ball. Couple of really costly turnovers so far from ESM already as Graham will take a seat.
Yeah,
not looking happy about that.
Both teams haven't been fantastic with the turnovers and whatnot. It looks like somebody who has access to my computer commented for me. Mikey is clearly the superior commentator. I believe that was Josh maybe on that comment. You know, Josh, I take that personally, but looks like ESM's going to take the ball away here.
Yeah, Anthony Sickle drove into the lane, and instead of fouling, Cole Thomas was able to force a jump ball and get the ball back to ESM. Here is Anthony Bryant, kicks out to Tyler Quarry, and here is Cole Thomas sizing up Cerrone. Thomas out to Bryant, sizes up Stickle, and he is fouled. That's a soft foul if I'm saying something.
Yeah, there's been a lot of those soft fouls in the lane for both teams. That's really going to – well, that's contributed so far to Trent Hughes' high foul count. Both teams might make a push towards the bonus here in the later half of the game, but that just slows down the game.
Bryant takes his first and misses again. ESM are 2 for 9 from the free throw line. If they made all of them, they would be only at a 1-point disadvantage. However, that is not how basketball works. Here's Bryant again.
Another
he misses
brick.
The second. He's there 2 for 10 now, but Cole Thomas gets the offensive rebound, so we'll see if it really matters that much. Here's Quarry sizing up Cerrone. Here's TH underneath. Henderson with absolutely no post moves. Trent Hughes bats it away, but Henderson gets the follow, gets the better of Hughes on the second attempt.
Yeah.
Fool me once, shame on you, but fool me twice, he's getting the better of Hughes on the second follow.
Yeah, so far in this second half, the TH matchup has gone the way of Tristan Henderson. Hopefully Hughes can find his rhythm. Hughes was huge in that first half, but now here's Cerrone.
And Cerrone just getting caught up, could not get on the same page as Hughes. It's taken away by Betts. Here's Bryant with an acrobatic finish, will be fouled by Sanders, and the ESM and Anthony Bryant will head to the line again. And as we know, these points are absolutely not guaranteed from Anthony Bryant. Has missed almost all of his free throws so far. And a large contributor to the 20% record for ESM as he takes his first and misses it again. Hits back iron. Cannot get anything going. Anthony Bryant, you know, free throws are one of those things that absolutely kills your mindset and your mental fortitude in this game.
Yeah, ESM has been absolutely ridiculously ice cold from the free throw line as another one rattles off the rim, but a foul's been called.
On Trent Hughes, I believe that'll be his fourth foul of the game.
I don't know.
Trent Hughes looks to be visibly upset, as that's just one of those fouls that you don't really see off the rebound of a missed free throw, but the ball will stick with ESM getting close to the bonus now. Here's Betts finding Bryant underneath. And Xander swats it away, and Stickle comes up with it. That could have been a foul, but I'm not going to say anything about that. As Bryant continues his cold streak, cannot get anything going from the field or the line.
Yeah, hopefully the Red Rams can cash in here, extend their lead. They're up by six right now at the moment. A long pass for Hughes. Red Rams, they can't make any careless mistakes. They almost made one there as Hughes tries to dunk over him. A little bit of a fail there if I...
And Trent Hughes just picked up a technical foul. And
technicals and on both teams. Technicals on both teams.
And if this call stands, Trent Hughes is out of this game. That'll be his fifth foul. Trent Hughes, let's rewind a little bit because he went to try and dunk that. And it looks like maybe he thought he was going to get fouled. Maybe he... said something he should have after missing the dunk attempt. We're going to see what this ends up settling down to, but if the call stands, that'll be Trent Hughes' fifth foul.
Yeah, I believe Trent is in foul trouble. Hopefully this won't. Oh, it looks like Trent's heading to the bench, and now officials having a conversation here. I don't quite know what's going on.
And when Trent Hughes committed that foul, Jeff Ike looked at him and said, hey, what are you going to do now? You're out of this game. There's nothing else you can contribute to this team. I know it's harsh, but Trent Hughes is going to have to stake out a seat for himself on the bench and cheer his team on. We're going to see a lot of minutes now from AJ Samita, possibly will stay in the entire game, playing the small ball five, and he's going to have to guard Tristan Henderson. This is huge for ESM.
Yeah, I still don't understand what was going on there with the technical. Maybe somebody who's watching at home can go back, rewind that, watch it for us, and let us know exactly what happened. Oh,
it
maybe
like he said something to the ref.
Hughes might have said something,
maybe begging for a call, maybe swearing, because I know refs take that very seriously. And now ESM are looking to feed Tristan Henderson down below as he has AJ Samita on him, but we know AJ Samita is no slouch on defense. As Tyler Corey mishandles it, goes off his thigh, and JD will retain possession with 11 minutes left in this game and 3 left in the third quarter.
Yeah, if you want to talk about momentum and just energy in the building, ESM, while they don't have a humongous student section, they do have quite a bit of people over there in the corner. They're all seated, all looking rather maybe, I wouldn't say depressed is a harsh word, but they're looking rather lack of energy, I guess you could say. The flock is up, they're vocal, and here's AJ Samita fighting for it, a foul is called, but yeah, the cacophonous cottage, quite rocking for the Red Rams, not quite for the Spartans.
Goodson's Garden is in full effect tonight. John Goodson, our wonderful athletic director, the man who loves JDTV more than anyone else. And this student section is showing out tonight. That snow day has absolutely nothing on us. Here's Anthony Stickle off the feed from Cerrone. Cerrone gets the hammer screen from Jake Ogata, but it
offensive
won't matter
foul.
As that is going to be an illegal screen from
offensive
Jake Ogata.
Foul.
A nice drawn-up play. But it won't matter. And it looks like a timeout is coming up for JD and Jeff Ike, looking to talk himself over after the loss of Trent Hughes. Not something he necessarily was planning for. And it looks like a special announcement is coming up at the end of the quarter, possibly something to do with the JDYAA boys. As it is JDYA night. I shouldn't say night because it's about 1:30, but it should have been last night. I'm actually a coach of a JDYA team of my own. I don't see any of my players out there right now, but it's always nice supporting the future of the program. I love to see it.
Yeah, JDYAA, what a feeder program for both lacrosse and basketball. I played a lot of JDYA basketball. Not very much, or I don't believe any lacrosse at all, but Little League Baseball is where it was at for me. But JDYAA, what a great organization, helping kids out, getting them out with their friends, competing, having fun on the weekends. But back to some varsity action here at Jamesville-DeWitt High School.
Here's Henderson sizing up the smaller Samita. Here's Bryant. trying to size up Stickle. Here's Henderson on the block again, but he's losing it, and it looks like, yes, he will be fouled by Jackson Cerrone. Samita had him locked. Henderson was going absolutely nowhere. His footwork has been lackluster all afternoon, but Cerrone swooped in to get the foul call, and it looks like ESM will soon find themselves in the bonus early on in the second half.
Yeah, Cerrone was looking to pick his pocket there, couldn't quite get anything to go. Another hack by Jake Ogata, and that basket will count as the Spartans cut this to just a four-point deficit with Cole Thomas heading to the line.
Cole Thomas, I was about to say how quiet he's been in the second half and really the entire game, and just as I was about to mention it, he gets his second and one of the game. The first time he made the free throw, let's see what he can do this time. And he misses front iron. As Giblin corrals it, here comes Zanders trying to push the pace with three sophomores on the floor for JD right now.
Yeah, JD running with that younger lineup. Two seniors out there. Now here's Stickle. Can't quite
connect. Stickle cannot get the three to go. Here comes Cole Thomas trying to push the pace a little bit. Cut the lead to four earlier on, hoping to do a little bit more of that. Cole Thomas with an acrobatic finish. Went off the hands of Stickle, I believe. Look to be Tristan Henderson. I think Henderson knows it. Him and Stickle are kind of jawing at each other just a little bit. But Cole Thomas will inbound. And I believe a foul was called. A push on Anthony Stickle. And Tristan Henderson will go to the line for two.
Henderson can't connect. The putback from Cole Thomas. The ball will stay with the Spartans, however.
ESM have had the ball for almost the last 3 minutes of this quarter. Just with JD missing so many shots and ESM retaining possession as well as they have. However, they still cannot get a bucket, and Trey Bova is no exception as Bova fouls Stickle on the follow. And it looks like, nope, JD are not in the bonus yet. Possibly a couple fouls away.
Yeah, Eamon took a tough fall there. Hopefully he's all right. Maybe bruised his tailbone, but he looks to be all right. Maybe a little shaken up, but the Red Rams really need to cash in here. Their lead has been cut down to just 4 points. Hopefully they can extend that a little bit, give them some more breathing room as we wind down here in the third quarter.
And Ian Delf is about to check in. I just saw Ike and Barlow talking things over very intently. Looks like Ian Delf will check back in for the remainder of the third quarter and possibly all of the fourth. Here's Samita in the corner. Have not seen him take a three yet, as we know he's very good at it. But he stepped out in the corner. Tristan Henderson was just too big for him. Another costly turnover.
Yeah, turnovers are going to really just cost both these teams down the stretch at the end of this game if they are both careless. But hopefully the Red Rams can limit those turnovers, play some smart basketball. And ooh, a nice play by Cerrone to jump up and take that away from Betts. Betts looks to be shaken up. He's still limbering on that ankle.
Here's Samita underneath. Finds Stickle. Stickle with the mid-range that he's known to do so often. And when the world needed him most, he arrived. Anthony Stickle, his patented mid-range jumper, gets it going. 36-30 for JD as ESM take their final possession of this quarter. As Betts is shaken up just a little bit, and it looks like AJ Samita has forced a turnover. He's loving it. The flock are loving it. And Betts is still shaken up. We saw him getting some treatment for his ankle during the second quarter. And it looks like he is still not his full self.
Yeah, the Spartans fans in the building did not like that call on that last play. They wanted a foul there called on the Red Rams. However, the ball will stay with the Red Rams here. They got about 20 seconds to go here in the third quarter, up by six. Maybe they can extend their lead possibly. Push it to eight at the end of this third quarter.
And as we know, JD are really bad in the third quarter, have been outscored in almost every game that they've played in the third quarter. But so far, they're holding their own. Here is Zanders underneath. Gets it off the glass, off the feet from Delfa. An eight-point lead for JD. Here's Combs with a half-court shot. Puts it over the basket, and that will be all she wrote for this third quarter of action. JD went into the halftime break with an eight-point lead, find themselves into the third quarter break with an 8-point lead. And here we will recognize the JDYA athletes. The crowd is loving it.
Ike right there, Coach Jeff Ike being vocal, telling Trent Hughes to, and I quote here, keep his mouth shut. You know, hopefully, I don't know if that means Trent Hughes appeared to slap the scorer's table. Maybe he's coming back in this game. Maybe we were just miscounting
there. Yeah, we could have been misinformed there. Yeah. I feel like I counted 5 fouls on him, but hey, you never know. Here we got our beautiful athletic director, John Goodson, shaking hands with all these JDYA players. Players that I've seen in a couple of practices so far. These guys, we got some solid players up in the program coming up. I would not be surprised if in 10 years' time I came back to this gym and found a couple of these guys doing exactly what we see. Anthony Stickle, Ian Delpha, AJ Samita, Trent Hughes, all these guys. As it looks like we were mistaken, Trent Hughes, despite the technical foul, that was only his 4th, I believe. So he'll be back into this game with what I believe is 4 fouls.
Dikembe Hughes back in the lineup for the Red Rams. His nickname given to him because of his presence down low, his presence on the board. You know, I've yet to see him throw one down in person, but I've been told it can be done.
And here's Delpha, got 8 minutes to work with, trying to bring his team to glory and even the season series between the Spartans and Red Rams. Obviously, we know Cole Thomas with that buzzer beater to crush the Red Rams' dreams last time out. But Ian Delpha is determined to make that not happen again.
Yeah, Delpha looking to make some shifty moves on offense. Hands off to his good pal Stickle, who's on the lane. Foul called on Tristan Henderson. You know, he's another big. You tend to see these bigs get into foul trouble down the stretch. I like to think Jesse Edwards as a great example for Syracuse
Burama
University.
Burama Sidibe.
Yes, a lot of guys.
Musa Kida, Pascal Chukwu, to name a few.
Yeah, those guys for Syracuse always tend to get into foul trouble down the stretch. So hopefully the Red Rams and the Spartans, if you're a Spartans fan, of course, will limit those fouls.
And here we go with Zanders to inbound. Looks like there could have been maybe a spill on the court as Jeff Ike is bringing out a towel to one of the referees. Looks like it is all squared away now. As Zanders will inbound once again, and looks like Giblin will check in for, let's see. Giblin will actually check in for Zanders. With 7:39 left, JD are rocking with 2 seniors, a junior, and 2 sophomores.
Yeah, the Red Rams with a very diverse lineup out there in terms of grades represented. All they're lacking is a freshman on this team, but hopefully with all these different experience levels, different personalities, they can find their way to a victory here. Up by 8, looking to make it a 10-point lead or an 11-point lead. Possibly even a 12-point lead, then get a 4-point play. That's pretty rare, but now
Thomas
strips it away. Ooh, a wonderful steal by Cerrone to chase that down.
Jackson Cerrone picking up the pieces where Ian Delpha could not. I feared we might have had an Andrew Graham dunk coming up, which as a Red Rams fan I would not have loved, but as a commentator I would have.
Yeah, it would have been very exciting.
But the Red Rams keep it on offense. ESM yet to touch the ball on offense so far in the first minute of the quarter. Here's Delpha, shakes Bryant, finds the cutting Hughes underneath. Hughes has fallen down. Here's Stickle trying to pick up the pieces. Stickle grades it in the corner. And he high-fives Ian McIntyre and Cade Fowler.
Let's go. An 11-point lead for the Red Rams. Just like I said, wow. Spartans, you know, they're kind of getting a little frustrated here. The Spartans in the building looking a little depressed, you could say.
Yeah, Anthony Stickle picks up the trash, turns it into treasure.
Yep, of
right
course.
In front of the flock, too. That is possibly the best spot to hit a 3. Every kid dreams of hitting a 3 in front of their student section. Like I said, slapping the hands of Ian McIntyre and Cade Fowler, some of the most vocal members of the flock. And advances the lead to 11 points.
Yeah,
a very comfortable spot.
Given a stop from the Red Rams, followed by another good trip down the way on offense, the Red Rams could open up a huge lead here, a quite commanding lead if they could. Hopefully, we'll see what happens.
And these last 7 minutes, we really need the flock to get loud. I do not want to hear a single minute of silence from them for the rest of 7 minutes.
And Aaron Coe, our camera operator here, he zoomed in on one of our friends from ESM. Not that we have many from ESM, but we do have our good friend Donnie. What's his last name? Well, I know him by Donnie. He's a great volleyball player. Good kid. But, yeah, he's a funny, goofy guy. So, shout out Donnie if you see this later.
And Tristan Henderson misses that, but will be fouled, not by Trent Hughes, thankfully. And like you were saying, we don't have many friends on ESM. I notice a couple of soccer players over there, a couple of lacrosse guys that we will be seeing on a JDTV broadcast in the spring. As here is Tristan Henderson, misses his first one, front iron. That one had absolutely no chance. Shouts of come on, Trissy, coming from Luke McQuaid, possibly a little volleyball rivalry carrying over. As Henderson cannot learn from his mistake, hits the front iron twice, a completely flat shot, zero arc on that one.
Yeah, the Red Rams up by 11. Just like I said, if they can convert on this possession, they'll be opening up a commanding lead. Here's a, oh, Stickle got fouled very hard, very hard.
Yeah, he was knocked over.
I sure hope Stickle's all right.
I think he'll be okay.
I see.
Saw him take a knock a little.
You know,
Stickle's
right in front of us here in the booth. I can see a red mark on the back of his neck as Aaron Coe, our camera operator, is distracted here. Whoa. Some violent language there from Aaron. We apologize for that. But now, here's Gibby to inbound to Stickle. Hopefully, like I was saying, hopefully Stickle's all right. Yes.
Here's Hughes from the free throw line. Cannot get it to go, but Stickle will bat it away from Cole Thomas as Cole Thomas still retains possession. Kicks it out to Betts, who's still kind of limbering around on that ankle. We'll see how much of a part that plays. Here's Bryant, shaken. But Hughes bats away the pass, the outstretched arms.
Yeah.
Almost a 7-foot wingspan from Trent Hughes.
That's Dikembe Hughes coming up clutch there on the defensive end with that big frame. Now here's Andy Giblin from three. Not even close.
Absolutely.
Sorry, Gibby, but
Giblin.
Gibby, that was not even close, buddy.
As Cole Thomas is now fouled by Jackson Cerrone. Looks like Ogata is about to check in. With 5:41 left in the fourth quarter and in this game, ESM got to get some offense going quick.
Yeah, finding themselves down by 11, under 6 to go. Not a place you want to be if you're a Spartans fan, but now a timeout has been called by the Spartans looking to talk this one over. You know, the Red Rams, they can get a few clutch stops here, a few baskets, and I think this one could get out of hand.
And Jeff Ike looking really paranoid right now. Obviously, I think his shirt is still somewhat tucked. As we know, that usually signifies some paranoia from Jeff Ike. But he looks nervous right now. Mm-hmm. He knows that an 11-point lead is absolutely not safe. And Aaron Coe, our cameraman, if you can, can you zoom in on Greg Lawson's shoes right now?
Those are some fire kicks, might I say.
Look at those. Oh, my.
The white and red Nike dunks. Ooh. Those are just absolutely impeccable.
Greg Lawson, I feel like he might have bought those the second he found out he was going to be the principal at JD.
Is he
those
a sneakerhead?
Beautiful.
You know, I'll have to ask him on Monday at school, is Greg Lawson a sneakerhead? Quite a interesting development there. Now,
not
here's Cole
I
Thomas.
Would expect from him. Here's Cole Thomas. Misses once again. ESM have missed over 10 free throws now. It's getting out of hand. It's just ridiculous.
Just like Fowler.
Just like Fowler. And Cole Thomas gets the friendly roll on the second to cut the lead to 10.
The Red Rams finding themselves up by 10. They are looking to get a couple more key baskets here as they go down the stretch.
Yes, and it also looks like they're going to waste as much time as they can off the clock. They have 35 seconds to work with on the shot clock. We'll try to use all that. Here's Cerrone for his fourth three of the evening. Excuse me, afternoon, but he can't get it. Jake Ogata tries to regain the loose ball. And Jake Ogata doesn't think he got it. He didn't get it. The ball will stick with ESM as Cerrone takes a break and Zanders checks back in.
I can't believe a foul wasn't called on ESM there. It looks like Trent Hughes was getting battered and bruised down below. Tristan Henderson appeared to apologize for Hughes for the rough contact, but nonetheless, the ball will go with the Spartans.
Here's Thomas backing down Stickle, as we've seen him do several times, trying to get the post moves, and he gets another and one. Cole Thomas, for the third time today, gets fouled and hits the shot. He's backed down Anthony Stickle and several other members of the Red Rams several times. But as we know, he's not a good free throw shooter. Gets it up and hits front iron like his friend Tristan Henderson several times a day. And with 5 minutes left, Stickle takes it up, trying to milk some clock.
Yeah, like
tickle, top of the key.
Like I was saying before, an important point for the Red Rams is to keep the Spartans from driving the lane, just like Cole Thomas did there. So hopefully they can figure out an answer for that. They haven't yet. But now the Red Rams with another costly turnover down below. They got to limit those if they want to win this game.
It seems like every time someone tries to find Jake Ogata on the block, the ball either gets batted away or gets thrown out of bounds. Not to any fault of Jake Ogata, but just an unlucky trend for the Red Rams. Here's Henderson backing down Hughes. Tries to get the reverse. Gets underneath the basket, behind the basket, scoops it underneath, and now the lead is cut to 6 for JD.
Yeah, JD finding themselves in a little bit of a slump, you could say, for scoring. Like baseball, you know, you just got to hit your way out of it, but hopefully the Red Rams can figure out a way to get out of this one.
Yeah, the Red Rams with not a lot of urgency and a lot of errant passes, they got to all get on the same page quickly or this can get out of hand.
Yeah. Spartans looking to put two defenders on one player, maybe some trap action, but now that one's nearly thrown away. Stickle grabs it somehow.
Stickle's only got 3 seconds to work with. And the ball will go out with 2 seconds on the shot clock. JD Ball, we're going to need a little catch and shoot opportunity.
Yeah, Coach Ike reminding his players, two seconds here. Who knows what the Red Rams can do with just the 2 seconds, but hopefully they can figure out something good.
I'm thinking Anthony Stickle will come off a Trent Hughes screen. Here's Sanders from way downtown. He puts it up and gets nothing but backboard.
Yeah, shot clock violation, unfortunately.
And another missed opportunity from JD. Have not scored a point in a really long time.
Yeah, the Spartans can cut this lead to a 3-point lead. Hopefully the Red Rams can lock up on defense, keep the Spartans from getting into the paint, which is what Henderson's trying to do right now. That was a little Kareem Abdul-Jabbar-like floater.
Yeah, ESM are getting everything down in the post. They have barely taken a three all day. Trying to exploit the size advantage as best as they can. And here's Cole Thomas backing down Jake Ogata, one of the strongest guys on this team. But he dishes down to Henderson, and Henderson cuts the lead to 4. Kisses it off the glass over Trent Hughes, and this lead is not safe for JD. Do not go anywhere. The once 11-point lead is now 4.
Yeah, and just like I said, ESM, the Spartans, they're going to continue to find their way into the post. I've been saying it nearly all game. The Red Rams got to find an answer. They got to keep the Spartans from getting down to those blocks, down to the paint. That's where Henderson and Cole Thomas, that's where they love to live. So hopefully the Red Rams can figure it out.
And Tristan Henderson completing the 3-point play, and this lead is down to 3 with 3 minutes left. JD have not scored a point in almost 5 minutes. They got to get some offense going quick.
Yeah, the Red Rams have gone very quiet on offense, but now here's Xander's in the lane like he likes to go, and he puts it up in! The
Alan
Red Rams.
Sanders.
The Red Rams bench loving that one.
Alan Sanders getting it done. Drives into the basket with absolutely no regard for human life. Picks up the foul, trying to extend this lead to 6. This is absolutely perfect timing for Alan Sanders. But this is not enough. Even if he makes the free throw, the contributions need to continue on the offensive end for JD. However, he misses it back iron, tries to corral, but Andrew Graham will do so instead. As here is Cole Thomas bringing it up.
Yeah, Coach Ike wanting his team to drop back and play solid defense here. Hopefully they can keep the Spartans out of the paint like I've been mentioning throughout this game. I mean, I'm no basketball expert, but I do watch my fair share of basketball games. And just like I said, I've been saying it the whole afternoon, the Red Rams got to keep the Spartans out of the paint as Tristan Henderson goes down to that left block and just does like he does, puts it up with the left hand off the glass and in for another 2 points. Still a 3-point lead for the Red Rams, though.
This is bad news for JD. Have only gotten one basket in a very long time. They got to get something moving or else ESM, this Spartan train could keep chugging along. Here's Delph out on the corner.
Yeah, wonderful give and go there for Xanders with Ogata.
Stickle scoops it up, cannot get it. Here's Cole Thomas.
Oh, a nice
Cole
play
Thomas,
there.
I think he traveled. But
oh, he threw it away.
Threw it out of bounds.
A careless turnover by Cole Thomas.
Now, I think he traveled somewhere in the middle of that.
Yeah,
looks
I hope
like
he enjoyed
JD
that trip.
Could have touched it, so the refs might have waved it off. But regardless, Thomas throws it out.
Either way, it looks like the Red Rams will end up with the ball here as Jeff Ike calls a timeout, trying to talk to his guys. This is a huge possession here for the Red Rams as they can take a 2-possession lead if they are to convert. Otherwise, Spartans really got a chance down here.
Man, and this is just one of those things that reminds you that in sports and in basketball, no lead is safe. You can work the entire 32 minutes to stake out a lead for yourself, and if you can't defend for that last second or that last attempt against your opponent, then all that work is for naught and all your hard work is gone. JD, you're suffering from that right now. Obviously, they still have a three-point lead with 2:11 left on the clock as they try to improve to 8-7 on the season, trying to knock ESM down to 8-10. As this game has huge implications for sectional seeding. As we know, in the new sectional format, every team, if they choose to, will be part of the sectional bracket. But seeding is still of the utmost importance, as JD will hopefully be able to host a home game too. Maybe one final broadcast on JD TV for the basketball season. As here is Zanders to inbound with 2 minutes left.
Yeah, the Red Rams, I don't believe they'll be able to make a run at winning the SCAC, their league. But hopefully they can win a couple more games, get themselves a nice seed in the sectional tournament for Class A, as the Red Rams are a member of the Class A division of the NYSPSHAA or whatever it's called.
Here is Xander sizing up. Here's Stickle on the wing. Finds Samita at the free throw line. Back out to Stickle. That ball is batted out. With 1:53 left on the clock, JD will keep the ball with 18 seconds to work with.
Yeah, JD really needs to cash in here. Looks like they got their starting most of their starting five minus Hughes out there. These are their solid guys they run with. Oh!
Oh, what are we doing, JD? Here's Graham. And Graham cuts the lead to one. An errant pass from JD. This is now a one possession game.
Eamon Giblin made a little bit of an errant pass there. The Red Rams got to get it over half court, and they turn it over. Here comes the Spartans down inside. A foul called on the floor.
And this game is eerily reminiscent to the 2020 matchup in the Hoops for Courage game between these two teams. I'll remind you of that. I remember it was Trey Autry. He was holding the ball for the final possession for JD. The game was tied. He tried to make a pass to Peyton Shumpert. The pass was taken away as ESM tied this game up. But like I said, the pass was taken away. A costly turnover meant an ESM win. And with two back-to-back turnovers resulting in two baskets for ESM, will bring ESM to a one-point lead.
Wow, a crazy turn of events here. Both schools becoming vocal. ESM fans getting back into it. Now the Red Rams looking to create some on offense.
And the team with an 11-point lead in the early stages of this quarter now find themselves down by one.
Eamon Giblin working down low on Henderson. Hopefully they can find something down there. As here he finds the driving Xanders, who puts it up.
But Xanders will go to the line for two. And it looks like the JD student section are waving to Tristan Henderson because he is going out of this game. He just picked up his fifth foul. He is gone, fouled out. Now the most impactful players of this game, but his night is done.
Yeah, the injured Betts coming back in. Who knows what kind of a presence he'll make us. He's been suffering that ankle injury as we saw him nursing that on the sidelines, but a big free throw here. And he connects. Way to go, Allen. That was a clutch free throw.
And Xanders to extend the lead to one.
Another big one here.
This is the most important shot of the game so far.
If he misses, look for a nice offensive rebound by the Red Rams. And he connects.
But he puts it down. The man with ice in his veins. The sophomore is never too shy for the spotlight. As Xanders cuts a one-point lead out for JD with 1:16 left. Ian McIntyre saying, this is our night. This is our court.
Yeah, this is going to be a huge end of game right here. The Red Rams holding on to that one-point lead. Very reminiscent of that last game at ESM High School. This is a crazy game. Crazy game. We'll see what happens here as teams go into timeout. Red Rams looking to lock up on defense, getting the ball back.
And the JD student section right now, they're telling us, this is our school. We need all you guys out here. All the support is necessary. We got 1:16 left. Let's close this thing out all together.
Yeah, let's see if we can lock in, get some nice chance going on the defensive end. Locking down on offense. The Spartans are going to look to push into the paint. The Spartans have lived down on those blocks. Henderson, Thomas. You know, who knows what will happen. Henderson probably will not be in the game. Henderson is out, yes. So it's going to be Cole Thomas maybe backing in on Stickle as he has all afternoon. But, man, the Red Rams got to find an answer.
Man, this is getting crazy. We are down to the nitty-gritty. Everyone in this gym knows it. This is where legends are made.
Yes.
If you close this game out, You change the course of the season. You become a legend in JD. And yeah. If not, everyone will always remember your shortcomings.
I couldn't agree more. Hopefully the Red Rams can get a stop right here. Austin Betts, he's been injured. Samita looking to lock up on him in a defensive stance. Betts drives, and he puts it in!
And Betts gets a one-point lead. This game is going back and forth. We're trading buckets, and JD got to get something going with 55 seconds left. Here's Samita to Stickle. Stickle drives, loses it momentarily. Is backed into a corner, but gets it back to Zanders.
Yeah, the Red Rams looking to dish and drive. He drives in, puts it up, jump ball called. Oh, it'll go with the Spartans. That is very unfortunate for the Red Rams. Gosh. Alan Zanders went up with the ball. He was taken down by a Spartan, resulting in a jump ball, and a timeout is called by the Spartans.
Oh, my goodness. Alan Zanders, I thought he was going to at least get fouled and get an attempt to tie and pull his team ahead. But a really smart play. I didn't even see who that was on ESM, but a heads-up play that we've seen a couple times, a couple of jump balls, and the ball will stay with ESM, as they look to extend their lead with 42.8 seconds left.
Yeah, unfortunate there. Well, now the Red Rams will have the possession arrow. Just 42 seconds to go. They really need some help here. The Red Rams are also not in the bonus, but I believe with their next foul, they will be in the bonus. So, we'll see what will happen here.
Man, I'm nervous. I'm jittering right now. Everyone in this room knows how important a JD win is tonight. A win puts them above 500 and gets them ahead of ESM in the seeding. A loss is extremely detrimental. They're currently on a two-game win streak, which is a nice little spurt of momentum. And with this game, if it ends up a win for JD, the whole school is going to be behind them going into the sectionals. Not that we already are not, but we need this.
Yeah, hopefully the Red Rams can get a turnover here as they will look to press. The Red Rams are in a press, but they will drop back to not allow any long passes here as Bryant, he's going to bring it up for the Spartans, guarded closely by Delpha. He gets past him, though, and a timeout called again. Another timeout. Coach Kilpatrick is very frustrated, but Mikey, we're going to cut to a quick segment that we've done here at JDTV for a long time. We're going to tell you what day it is out there. Mikey, take it away.
All right, so there's a couple of national days today. Today is National Play Outside Day, which is actually the first Saturday of every month. I don't know if any Syracuse residents will be celebrating because it is quite literally the coldest day of the year.
Yes, yes.
There's also National Ice Cream for Breakfast Day. There's also National Hemp Day. Don't know if we'll be covering that anymore. It's also National Homemade Soup Day. So
nice.
Maybe on this cold little afternoon, maybe curl up into a ball, watch some basketball on your couch with some nice cold soup. It's also National Create a Vacuum Day.
Yeah.
I don't know if they mean a vacuum cleaner or like a vacuum between space and time.
You know, I'm not feeling like much of an astrophysicist today, but that's quite interesting.
And lastly, it is National Thank a Mail Carrier Day. So get out there, say thank you to your mailman or mailwoman.
Yeah,
tell him have a great day.
I'm going to thank my grandfather. He's lived in New Hampshire his whole life. He served in the Air Force during Vietnam. He also was a mail carrier and worked for the Postal Service for over 40 years. Shout out to my pa. I hope you're listening at home. Shout out Portsmouth, New Hampshire. I hope you guys are doing well.
And here come ESM with their final possession. JD just got to get a stop here, but Bryant is fouled by Alan Zanders, and Bryant, the man who is ice cold from the free throw line. That is Micah
foul.
Combs, actually, not Anthony Bryant. Micah Combs, I'm not sure if he has taken a free throw yet today.
Yeah,
but
we
if
got
he can
some
sink these, it will get the game to a 3-point game.
Yeah, we got some absolutely humongous free throws coming up. This free throw will shape the game, and he misses.
And he misses
off
front iron. We still have a chance. Do not go anywhere.
Yes, the Red Rams with 25 seconds to go. The shot clock is turned off. So, it could be a buzzer beater, but, you know, the Red Rams might push the pace as here comes a free throw to make it a 2-point lead.
Combs puts it up.
He
hits back iron.
The Red Rams corral it.
Gets it. And a
timeout called by Coach
Ike. By Jeff Ike. 23 seconds left. JD have the ball. The shot clock is off. They are down by one. All you need is one basket. One field goal does it. I believe, if I had to guess, I'd say the ball would be in Stickle's hands. I'd say he would keep the ball for about 15
around that second quarter.
That's when I think he'll go to work because it gives him
up a shot and
an offensive rebound as well.
Yeah, this is just a huge, huge possession here for the Red Rims. Finding themselves down by one. It's not tied, so they need to get a basket. Possibly could head to the free throw line to force overtime, but I don't feel comfortable with that situation, as down the stretch it looks like the Spartans have been outplaying the Red Rams here. So, yeah, I would like to see the ball in the hands of Anthony Stickle, possibly Ian Dolfo for a nice perimeter shot. I would also like to see a nice drive by Alan Zanders. Maybe he can head to the free throw line or get a nice tough layup, contested layup look there.
So does that mean you're ruling out the possibility of Trey Evans checking into this game to make a game-winning three?
You know, I love you, T. Evans, but I don't think you'll be seeing the court on this one, buddy.
Okay, valid reasoning. I don't know if I agree, but I digress. 23 seconds left. The stage is set. Looks like Stickle will inbound to Delpha. Got to clear it past half court first. And with 20 seconds left, it all comes down to this.
Yeah, this is just an absolutely huge possession.
15 seconds. Make that 10 seconds. Here's the Rooney. Off the mark. Air ball. Oh, it's made. The Red Rams will make possession. What a turn of events. The Rooney crawled up in the air.
Wow, Jeff
Ike is very close.
Tim, he's made.
He's
made.
Billboard.
Three for four.
This is amazing.
He's not.
Oh my goodness.
He's been
lit
up all day. We haven't.
Wow. Just wow. I have no.
I mean, if you're.
All right. We are back. We have 7 seconds left. JD will inbound from the baseline. All you need is a basket. I'm thinking maybe try and hit a cutter, drive into the basket, and maybe draw a foul, because in that case, you know, worst case scenario, you just get fouled and you go to the line and you only have to hit one to force a tie. But you also are taking a very high percentage shot. Man, as a JD fan, I am nervous, but as a broadcaster, boy, am I excited.
Yeah, this is just what you love to see in high school sports. It all comes down to this. A one-point game, 7.6 seconds on the clock. The Red Rams to inbound. The Spartans, they have their height in there in Aiden Betts. However, he is injured. Or Austin Betts, excuse me. And the Red Rams, they don't have much height in there. Looks like their tallest player is, in fact, Eamon Giblin. Maybe we'll see a perimeter shot here.
One basket wins it.
Let's
Anthony
see what
Stickle
happens.
To inbound. What can we do? Here's Delpha in the corner. Finds Cerrone. Finds Zanders.
Yes.
And the ball is tipped out.
It'll stay with the Red Rams.
Stay with the Red Rams. 2.4 seconds left. Got to get a shot up.
The Red Rams wasted a lot of clock, unfortunately.
Yeah, we're going to need a catch and shoot, maybe a nice drive to the basket. It all comes down to this.
This is it, folks. For the game, on the line, let's see what the Red Rams will do. Zanders will inbound. He finds Stickle.
Here's Stickle from way deep for the game! And
no.
He misses in front iron! Anthony Stickle had the game in his hands. Took the final shot on senior night. Coach Ike trusted him, as he has all season. But the tale as old as time, Spartans versus Rams, ends with a one-point Spartans win on the back of a heroic performance from Cole Thomas, Tristan Henderson, Austin Betts, all those ESM Spartans. Spoil senior night here at Jamesville-DeWitt.
Yeah, just not what you like to see if you're a Red Rams fan, you know. I'd like to commend the boys for their effort, all the seniors, what this team means to them. I know that was not the outcome they wanted, but, you know, they gave it a good fight. They really hustled down the end, and ESM, they were able to get the ball down in the paint just so much on the glass. Henderson and Cole Thomas both had amazing games for the Spartans. Jackson Cerrone had the hot hand for a while for three from the Red Rams. The Red Rams have a lot to learn from this matchup, you know, going into sectionals. A lot of things they can work on in practice. Now they know what they need to perfect down the way. But, yeah, that's all I have to say on the matter.
And this game just shows you that absolutely nothing is promised in this game. The Red Rams were up by 11 points in the fourth quarter, but just could not close it out. The Red Rams move to 7-8 on the season as ESM moves to 9-9. And that is all for us on this beautiful Saturday afternoon. Thank you so much for tuning in to JDTV. My name is Michael Meskos. This is Will Cooper. Thank you so much to everyone watching. Stay tuned. Make sure you hit that subscribe. We have a couple more basketball games coming up as we will be into lacrosse season very soon. But thank you very much for watching, and have a great night wherever you may be.